Nashville is like Target. You don't have allergies when you go in, but it'll tell you you have allergies when you're here for a few years.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Now, as a guy who takes like all kinds of allergy medication, I've had allergies all my life.
You have so many that your doctor says, how are you standing?
Oh, yeah. If you shake me, you can hear all the pills I have to take for allergies.
Like a maraca.
Exactly.
This is the Woody and Jim Show podcast, over 1,000 episodes strong. A daily recap of everything you missed.
Now, Ricky, you and your boyfriend AJ went to Australia together.
Yes, we did, for the longest trip that we've ever taken as a couple.
Uh-huh.
And we predicted this would be a big test for
your
relationship.
It's a telling moment, yes.
Yeah. And I didn't really think that it would be because we've been together for 4 years
now.
So
you pretty much know each other pretty well
already.
Yeah,
we've lived together forever, it feels like. So I was like, oh, I know him. It's not going to be that weird. But I learned something about him that was very upsetting for me.
Okay.
When we were on our flight to Australia, we had to take two flights there because we were in New Jersey for a wedding. So from New Jersey to San Francisco and then from San Francisco to Australia. The last leg was 15 hours.
That is awful.
It's not
as bad as you think.
A long time.
So fun fact, really not that bad. But it was bad in the sense that I learned something about AJ while we were flying.
Okay.
Oh, God. Something you can't unlearn.
Something I can never unlearn. AJ is one of the passengers on the plane that takes his shoes off during a flight.
I'm one of those guys, too.
Jim, gross! Why would you do that?
Don't put your nasty, socky feet everywhere.
Yeah.
I have hot feet.
Ew.
And so you want me to smell them?
Yeah,
that makes
no.
it sound even worse. I have hot feet.
Oh, but they don't smell. They're great.
That's a lie. I don't care what you say, Jim. But he took his shoes off and he's walking around the plane. And I was like, why are you doing
that? Okay, I would not do that.
He wears his socks and he would put them on, like he would put his shoes back on if he was going to the bathroom, which I was like, thank God. Because that was about to be the line that could not be crossed.
Yep.
If he wore his socks into the bathroom on the plane. Because you know, men, I'm sorry, but there should be a rule that you have to sit in the plane bathroom
because when you hit turbulence, it's like some sort of water
it's
wiggle.
It's all over
thing
the sides of the bathroom. It's all over the ground. I was like, if he does not put his shoes on to go to the bathroom, I will break up with him right here, right now on this plane.
In the sky.
And our vacation is going to be real weird for the next 2 weeks because we are not going to be dating anymore. But I don't know if I can actually get over that because I think that's one of the most disgusting things that anybody could do is take their shoes off on the plane.
Oh, my God. I'm one of those people.
Oh, my God. But, it's disgusting.
But I would never get out of my seat without putting my shoes back on. Mm. Never
it's
have.
Still disgusting. Either way. I don't want any random human being near me without their shoes on in a contained box of air.
Right.
With your stinky toes.
Yeah, it's bad enough that I have to breathe the same air that you are breathing as a stranger, let alone the air that now your feet
I'm going to stick up for AJ and just say, do you really want somebody's feet consistently stewing for 15 hours?
Yes, I do. Because that has nothing to do with me.
I want them
then
contained
you can cool
in
your
shoes.
Feet off later in the privacy of your hotel room.
Yeah, like that's a you problem, not a me problem.
Circling
keep it in
air,
the shoes.
Recirculating, it's fine.
No.
I've seen people take their shoes and socks off.
No.
I would never do that.
See, if somebody's behind you doing that, what you do is you take your socks off and drape them over the back of your seat.
To play this game.
Give them a little bit of their own medicine back there. Wow.
But yeah, I'm not happy about it.
We can never go on a vacation with him again.
Not a long
I love
flight,
you said
at
we.
Least.
Yeah.
That's all he's thinking about is like group vacations.
Did you just invite yourself on group vacation with him and then say you wouldn't do it?
I just traded places with AJ. He can no longer go, so I'm going in his place.
Trending. Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River.
Brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate. You know, gas prices have a lot of people trying to do tricks to save gas.
Yeah.
Experts looked at some of these and said, no, that's BS.
Okay.
Like saying, leave the engine running when you stop, because if you turn it on and off, you'll burn more gas. But they say modern fuel injectors make it, you just use a very little small
amount. That's an old
amount.
School thing.
That's like grandpa's car.
Yeah.
Was like that.
Rolling through stop signs, because they say if you stop completely, it costs more gas when you get going again. But they do mention that's why they call them stop signs, because you should stop.
Sorry.
Also, you'll
gas.
Get a ticket, and the ticket will cost you more than filling your gas.
4 cents you might save.
Yep.
And also say, people have said, turn your engine off when you're coasting downhill. You could save gas, but you'd also lose control of the car and
yeah,
die.
Yeah, what in the heck?
I always heard that if you put it in neutral as they're going downhill, that it's supposed to be better for your gas mileage.
That might be true.
I don't think that's a smart idea either. Don't do any of those things.
Well, you know, and if you turn it all the way off, you're going to lose your power steering and everything. So, yeah.
That's dumb.
Go right in the ditch. Ricky, what you got?
So the Duffer Brothers have talked about a spinoff to Stranger Things. They were recently on a podcast where they basically said that it's going to be 1,000% different from Stranger Things. They also said, they basically confirmed it won't be about 11 or Steve and Dustin, which are two of the options that people keep putting out there. Is that there'll be a spinoff on those. They were like, you know, we focus so much on both of those things that it would be kind of silly to do a spinoff for them.
Yeah.
They said that it'll be something that no one expects, not even Netflix.
Surfer dude.
And they also...
Pizza guy.
Yeah, the pizza guy. I like
him. The pizza guy is great.
I love him.
They also said that they want to pass the baton to a new creative team.
Okay.
Okay, they're ready to move on.
Yeah, I guess so. It seems that they're ready to do other things. So there's a lot going on there. We'll see what ends up happening. But don't expect an 11 spinoff or anything that you think that you know what it's going to be. They're saying it's not going to be any of those things.
Perfect.
All right, who's next?
Jim.
Jim, it's all you.
Well, Jim... Let me tell you this. remember yesterday I mentioned that there was groups of guys going to see the Minions movie, all dressed up in formal wear. They called themselves Gentle Minions. And so they go to the kids' movie and they dress up in like really sharp clothes and, you know, get their popcorn and sit down at this little kids' movie. And it was really funny on TikTok. Well, apparently we can't have nice things because... Now some theaters are banning people from coming in with formal wear dressed up because those people on occasion are doing bad things while the movie is playing, like throwing things at the movie screen or disrupting other people. One movie theater in London had actually stopped showing the movie completely because too many people were showing up and causing trouble.
I was thinking it would be like a brilliant way to pick up single moms. Like, go in your most dapper outfit, go try to pick up a single mom at the Minions.
She's there with the kids, and
yeah.
You're trolling at the Minions movie for
shit. Desperate
people have done worse.
Yeah, that's true. I absolutely,
yeah. Yeah, that's true.
It's like the new Wedding Crashers.
Right?
No kidding. Coming up next Tuesday is going to be our final River on the Rooftop with Kane Brown, Knightley, and Benson Boone. You can be a VIP. That means you don't have to stand in line. You get up close. It's kind of a cool thing. You can be that right now. Got a couple of them for you. 615-737-9107. Since Roe v. Wade has been overturned, a lot of men are choosing to get vasectomies.
I don't know if a lot of men are choosing to, but some are.
I think a lot of their ladies
Some have
ladies
made that
are
decision.
Going,
okay. Some have been told.
It's time for you to do
you
this.
You go get snipped.
Yeah.
But it's kind of cool. Daddy's Dogs, which is a famous hot dog place.
Oh, they have the so best good. Hot dogs here.
They are offering a free milkshake to anybody who can show proof of a vasectomy.
I love them so. I love Daddy. I love his dogs. I love his promotion.
It's so out of the ordinary. It's awesome.
As a guy who's had one, I would say
a hot dog or a vasectomy.
Good question.
Yes to both.
Only the vasectomy.
Okay.
Milkshake is like not the biggest incentive. Like, I mean, that's nice.
Well, they always
like,
say if you have it done, you can get like frozen peas and put it on there. Maybe you can use a milkshake for the same thing.
I wouldn't even drink the milkshake. I mean, just hold it over that area for 3 or 4 days.
Yeah.
Because, you need that.
I've heard it's really not that bad. I've heard that it's like a really quick procedure and it's really not that bad. My dad got one. Because after my brother, he was like, no more. I'm done with this.
It's a relatively quick procedure. It's... It can be different for
other
people.
I'm sure it's different for everybody. I've just heard that it wasn't that bad.
If you show proof of a vasectomy or a limp, you can get a free So obviously, their milkshakes bring all the sterilized boys to the yard.
They sure do.
They could teach you, but they'd have to charge. Stop by Daddy's Dogs.
If you've had a vasectomy,
stop by the doctor's office first.
Yeah.
They go to
get
Daddy's
you a milkshake.
Dogs.
Zach has got your celebrity stuff brought to you by California Closets Nashville.
We all remember the tragedy that was Astro World, where a bunch of Travis Scott fans, like, unfortunately passed away after they were, like, rampaging the stage and, like, trampling all over people.
It's awful.
Yeah, it was awful. So Travis Scott is back on tour. He was in Coney Island last night, and I guess a bunch of people decided to start like scaling the steel scaffolding of the stage, like literally climbing up the side of the stage. There was even a guy dressed as Spider-Man, which
of course, he had that planned.
Yeah. 100%. He went in with a motive.
Yeah.
So thankfully, Travis Scott actually saw what was going on this time and was able to stop his show in the middle of it until everybody calmed down, climbed off the scaffolding. So
nobody
got hurt last night, and it looks like he learned his lesson.
Because, yeah, he used to encourage that, but now,
Yeah, 100%. Right. And so he was able to be like more aware of his surroundings and the possibilities of what happens when people do that. So I'm glad that he learned and that everybody still got to have a good time at a show last night.
Yeah.
Except
awesome.
For the guy in Spider-Man costume.
Oh, is it ever a bad day to be dressed like Spider-Man? No, I don't think so. Woody and Jim in the morning, 107.5 The River. Look at us. We got the whole band back together. All you world travelers and me.
All right. Should we just talk about this elephant in the room that is Woody's bitterness towards
everybody
else? No, I'm not
bitter. I'm not bitter. I just had a staycation, you know, for a couple days, and you guys went all over the world.
You just
no, not kind of
staycations are nice, though.
Yeah. I got.
But you've casually mentioned it several times in the last 10 minutes.
It's not bitter. Get your vacation bitterness out of here, Jim.
I'm not the one going.
No. So yeah, go to bed early. You know, I take lots of naps. You know, I never leave the house. It's like all the punishments when I was a kid is now my goal.
Yeah.
You should just have an ankle bracelet on.
I don't know how that works, isn't it?
Yeah, it's not bad. But, Zach, you went to Baltimore on purpose. Jim, you went to Baltimore not on purpose.
Yeah, I went up to go see my boyfriend's family. So we went to Puerto Vallarta, Mexico, landed. The next day we flew to Baltimore to go see his family for the weekend. So we got home yesterday.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it was fun.
And then a big sweaty river on the rooftop in between. So, you know, it was go,
yep,
go, go.
Was yeah. home for 12 hours and then went to go work the Five Star show and then flew out that night. Yeah. It was very fun.
And then because I was part of the total airline industry cliche these days, which is like every time you fly, I got stuck in Baltimore 2 times. I had to buy hotel rooms in Baltimore just because that was the city where I was supposed to change planes.
Yeah.
That never happened twice.
That never changed.
Twice in 10 days. I had to pay like $100 a night for like a flea bag hotel. Yeesh. Right near the airport.
Did you check for bed bugs?
No, because
you don't look. Then, yeah, you don't look.
I don't want to know.
Yeah.
Ignorance is total bliss.
You just wake up in the middle of the night itchy.
Is Baltimore the bed bug capital of the world?
No, I just know that every time you travel, you're supposed to check for bed bugs before you lay in the sheets.
Yeah. And it also kind of depends on what hotel you're in.
Yeah.
Sleep in the bathtub.
Which they also don't clean.
Yeah. Exactly. They clean less than the bed. And Ricky, you were in Australia and you were just taunting us with how nice the weather is.
Oh my God,
there
it's
right now.
Gorgeous there because it's winter in Australia, which blows everybody's mind because nobody realizes that they have winter, but their winter is like our fall. So every day the max it got to was like 70 degrees.
Beautiful.
Every night was like 55. We were wearing a hoodie and you're walking around and it's cozy.
So it wasn't like that like bag of gummy worms that you left on the dashboard of your car while you went into like Walgreens for a minute and it came out and it was just one big
giant
melted.
That is a very specific example. And
a
no.
horrible pool of gummy bear.
It is not like that at all.
If there's tragedy, I have a complimentary example in candy form for pretty much anything you can describe.
Pretty much. Yeah, it works.
That is a fascinating skill, Jim.
I like candy.
You guys traveled the world. I got an interesting DM on Instagram. Whether you know it or not about me, you know that fashion is my passion. And I have a distinct style. I usually wear, Hawaiian shirts and look like a homeless Hawaiian man.
Yeah.
You know,
and I got to say, like, 3 out of 5 days a week, you bring something new to the fashion table.
Oh, yeah. I don't do, I just buy new clothes.
He never wears it twice.
I don't do laundry. I just wear a shirt and burn it. But I had an interesting and kind of disturbing DM on Instagram.
I'm scared.
Because posting pictures, I was with my girlfriend Melissa. We were in Kentucky, and I was wearing a Hawaiian shirt that had a lot of pineapples all over it.
Okay.
And so somebody,
I think I know where this is going.
Somebody sent me a tweet from BuzzFeed saying, people were sharing their hidden dress codes, and it says, when people wear pineapples, it means They're swingers.
Ooh, Woody.
So are you trying to send messages?
No, they just sent that and just a bunch of question marks underneath it. And we're like,
well, I think we've got question marks too.
You know, if they're looking at me as a swinger, you could really do better.
Oh, Woody.
Are you saying this means that the state of swinging is
yes.
in a bad place?
Somebody is setting their bar pretty low if they're looking at me. But I just like pineapples. I have actually heard in the past, I've heard from people that if you are a swinger, if you go through like Publix or Kroger with an upside down pineapple in your shopping cart.
Oh, sure.
That's supposed to be a signal to other swingers that you are ready to swing.
Oh. Zach and I met swingers in PCB, and
we did
ask this question.
About
they
the pineapples?
Said that they don't do that.
Is that
personally?
For, is
it
that
might
for
just
amateurs?
Be what they don't. Maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe they're just so, like
for the newbies.
That's
they
like
said
the
they
people
don't do
only
that,
get
though.
Crazy drunk on New Year's.
Yes, so, and they think they're
the
doing
amateurs.
Something.
Okay.
Yeah, right.
So real swingers don't wear pineapples.
Yeah, no, I don't think so.
They don't need pineapples.
Based off the one couple of swingers that we met.
100% of the couple we surveyed says. All right, well, I can rest easy then.
Yeah, now you can wear your pineapple shirt and not even think twice about it.
So I actually just got a new one. It's got pineapples, got sunglasses on. So.
Oh, that's cute, though.
It is adorable.
My daughter is mortified when she moved into her apartment because it already had a pineapple, like, on the door, like, right next to the, you know, thing where you peep out to see who is at the door. It had, like, a little metal pineapple
ornament.
Yeah,
like a little door knocker type thing.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, and since it's an apartment, she's not allowed to change it or anything, so she's like, I don't like this.
So people just knock on the door and peek in there and go, we know what you're doing in there.
Oh!
Why does everybody knock on the door with a robe?
It's time for men and women to answer questions for gender wars.
Gender Wars brought to you by nobody, because our sales department is rather incompetent. Let's meet our contestants for the
That's
ladies in the audience.
Whoa!
Madison in Spring Hill. Hello, Madison.
Hello.
Good morning.
For the guys, we have Mason in Nashville. Hello, Mason.
Good morning.
Hello, friend.
Welcome to the show. Let's do a Get Acquainted question. Madison, is there ever been a movie so bad that you walked out of it?
Yeah, it's not popular opinion, but the Hook movie with Robin Williams.
Oh, with Robin Williams.
Yeah.
I couldn't take it. I know.
I didn't
like
it either.
I feel bad.
Yeah. I'm with
Too
you.
Soon.
It's a little hard to,
Too soon,
you know, 45-year-old Peter Pan.
Yeah, I just couldn't take it. I just didn't know what was going on, and it just, I don't know. I just couldn't do it.
It's okay.
You.
You're entitled to your opinion,
you're
even
okay.
if it's wrong.
No, I'm with you.
What about you, Mason? Is there ever a movie that you walked out on?
Yeah, it was a movie called Tenet. It's about time travel.
Oh, yes. It's a Christopher Nolan movie, right?
That was a very confusing movie.
Really mind-hurting
Pretty intense,
movie.
Yeah.
I came here to escape. I didn't come here to do math and physics.
No, I can't do the math, so I already hate it.
All right. We have a screw for both of you. If you don't know the answer and you don't think your opponent knows your question's answer either, you can use your screw and make your opponent answer your question.
Here we go. Multiple choice, Madison. Is Canton, Ohio, the home of the football, baseball, or basketball Hall of Fame?
Oh, God. Basketball.
No. It's football.
All right. Was the Peach Pit a favorite hangout in the Gilmore Girls, Beverly Hills, 90210, Saved or Saved by the Bell? Mason.
Wait, can you repeat the choices again?
Yes. Is the Peach Pit a favorite hangout on the Gilmore Girls, Beverly Hills 90210, or Saved by the Bell?
Gilmore Girls?
No.
It was
no.
Beverly Hills 90210.
Okay. Yeah. Okay, no points still yet. Tied.
Madison, as seen in the Top Gun movies, they fly F-18 jets. What does the F stand for?
Oh. Screw.
Hmm. All right, Mason, what does the F in F-18 stand for?
Fighter.
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 Yeah.
Okay.
I was thinking fast.
It's a fast 18.
That's a fast 18 right there.
Yeah, let's everybody just say, get to your fast 18s.
Instead, it's like fast 13, faster 14.
That's the safest word I thought you were going to come up with.
That's not the first F word I think you thought of,
Okay, it is a 1-0 lead for Mason, and if he gets this one right, he could have an insurmountable lead.
Okay, Mason, you buy a trundle for your small apartment. What is that?
It's like a small bed.
Yes,
it is.
It is a small bed.
And there's no way, Madison, you could come back. Sorry.
Sorry, Madison.
It's like the game walked out on you.
Ouch.
Feels so bad. But we enjoyed having you.
Yeah. We hope to play again soon.
Mason, for you, we have tickets to the Music City Brewers Fest, July 23rd at Walk of Fame Park. So you hang on the line. We'll get those to you. Everybody else, will you be a contestant on Gender Wars tomorrow? Are you brave enough? It happens at 7:20.
Yes.
So there's this particle collider in Europe that is like quantum physics, like at its like most complex, and it is like this underground circle that is throwing like particles of
sounds
atoms.
Very familiar.
Yeah,
yes.
Like light speed.
Sounds a lot like Stranger Things.
Very familiar.
Right? But it's a
can we call it an underground lair? Or no, let's call it the upside down.
Yeah, it's in the upside down. It's literally a 17-mile wide circle underground in which they accelerate particles of like atoms and collide them at each other. It's called a collider. And
the scientific name for it is Collider.
And like, I don't know, about 10 years ago, they found like a whole bunch of like quantum physics, like revelations, like, oh, this is amazing. And but then they shut it down for a while because it's been like, I don't know, down for maintenance or it's like the shake machine at McDonald's.
Yeah. So, sorry, the collider machine is broken.
They probably realized just how powerful this was.
Yeah. That's
why
destroy
they shut
us
it
all.
Down.
Well, and they shut it down to make it more powerful.
Ah-ha-ha.
Perfect.
And they, after 3 years of upgrading the large...
They built a second Death Star.
Hadron Collider. They are starting it back up. And people all over the world are thinking that they're using it to open a portal to hell. Okay, so they're doing
it. Are we already living in it?
Seriously?
On purpose?
Well, I mean, like... The people doing it, I don't think, say that they're
scientists
doing
in black robes underground. But going, people, yes,
people
our Lord
who
and Savior.
Check out the scientists are thinking that they're trying to open a portal to hell. You know, they're trying to find out what happens when super particles collide at near the speed of light. But the rest of us who watch Stranger Things believe that it is, you know, some kind of entrance to Doctor Strange's multiverse of madness or the upside down. And I'm not totally writing this one off.
Well, you know, the way the world is right now, why not?
Yeah. Open it up. Suck us in.
I mean, do we have heat index over 100 degrees? How much hotter could it get?
Accurate, though.
Some of the evidence they cite is apparently it's CERN is a like acronym for the organization that runs this thing, and their logo has a 666 in it.
Great,
is what they say. That's,
does it actually though?
I'm checking it out.
Okay, because you know people go
they
stretch
see,
this.
They
so
see
far.
Sixes. They see devil worship everywhere.
Snopes.
Anything that's even slightly Snopes-ass out of thing. The range of what we understand, they're like devil.
Right?
Yeah. But, you know, this is pretty crazy because if it does end up doing something insane like this, that'll be massive and nothing else will matter anymore. But at some point, we got to get there, you know?
If it is a portal to hell, I mean, can we, like, charge for a place in line to, like, stand to throw things into it?
To see where it goes.
Or just to get rid of it.
Imagine you throw it in and it comes back and hits you in the head. It's like, joke's on you. You're already in hell.
That's what you get.
That's right.
We need Eddie Munson to play Master of Puppets.
Right. You are the upside down.
Yes.
Yeah. Joke's on you guys.
Yeah. Wherever it's going, it sends it back.
Yep. Comes right back, hits you right in the back of the head.
That's pretty bad. Yeah. Vecna says, you know, I feel sorry for you guys. It's kind of nice down here by comparison.
For those of you that haven't seen Stranger Things this season yet, there is, just like Kate Bush is running up that hill, near the end of this season, Metallica's song "Master of Puppets" gets a major play in the series.
And it's going up the charts on iTunes and Amazon.
They're getting the Kate Bush bump, is what they're calling it.
Yeah,
and Metallica's loving it. I think anybody who gets their song into Stranger Things is saying, yeah, please. Like, everybody, Billy Ray Cyrus is submitting songs right now.
Give me a paycheck.
I don't know how Achy Breaky Heart works, but
they could make it work.
Just put it in there.
They could make it work.
I could use another mansion.
Woody and Jim in the morning on 107.5 The River.
Here's a cool story. A little girl on board an airline's flight from Norway to South Carolina was distraught because she got off the plane and realized that she lost a tooth while they were in the flight and didn't know where it was. So they said, I have to go back on the plane and check for my tooth because I have to leave it out for the tooth fairy. And they, of course, already had gone through security and baggage claim and everything, and the plane was gone. So they figured, well, I guess it's lost. A United Airlines pilot decided to write a note to the tooth fairy and said, please accept this letter on behalf of Lena, who lost her tooth, and still be able to leave her money under her pillow.
That's so cute.
She left the note under the pillow and got money the next day.
That's very
sweet. The tooth fairy
is
very understanding.
Oh, yeah.
And I guess her mom said, obviously, it's nice to hear something cool and nice happening on an airliner.
Yeah,
these
seriously.
Days, you need these good things.
Yeah, no kidding. That's what's making us happy this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River.
TikTok thing that's going crazy with this guy has a test for dating. Uh-huh. And this is apparently foolproof for him.
Okay.
He calls it the allergy test.
You want to know my number one piece of dating advice? Ask if they have allergies. You're like, okay, yes, that makes sense. I don't want to send my future potential partner into anaphylactic shock. That's not why. I mean, yes, but you're looking for one of two answers. The first is, yes, I have allergies. Great. Second is, and this is very important, no, I don't have any allergies that I know of. That second part, vital, because here's the thing. I have never met somebody that I could trust who flat out says, I don't have any allergies.
Oh.
Huh.
So they're a liar.
Basically.
That's kind of what he says. He does have, like, anecdotal evidence.
Yeah.
He has evidence that we'll let him present coming up in just a couple of minutes. But
I'm intrigued.
Do you trust somebody who says, I have no allergies whatsoever?
Or is it a deal breaker?
Or is it just is that just ridiculous?
Does he get specific about what's wrong with them?
Yeah.
He does. He gives a specific piece of evidence about the do you have allergies test.
I don't trust it. And here's my case study, right? Because you're telling me you've never had a nose that itches or an eye that waters? No. Here's my case study. College, a coworker started dating this guy. He always came to the front desk. We worked at the library together. And she was like, Dutch, can I trust him? I said, allergy test. She said, what? I said, do the allergy test. She did the allergy test. And he said, no, I don't have any allergies. I never have. And I never will. 2 years later, he's living in Idaho with 7 women and started a religious cult.
Okay.
Well, obviously that was a gateway.
As one does.
I'm going to prove it by joining a cult in Ohio.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he's saying that, if they're adamant about it, like they don't have them and they never will, that there's something like psychologically wrong with them.
Well, nobody can say, and I never will.
Yeah. You don't know what you will and won't have.
Right.
Nashville is like Target. You don't have allergies when you go in, but it'll tell you you have allergies when you're here for a few years.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Now, as a guy who takes like all kinds of allergy medication, I've had allergies all my life.
You have so many that your doctor says, how are you standing?
Oh, yeah. If you shake me, you can hear all the pills I have to take for allergies.
Like a maraca.
Exactly. So, like, I do get a little angry with a few people that I've come across that I know that, like, proudly parade the fact that I don't have allergies.
Oh.
Like I have something to do with it.
Like it's a condescending, humble brag.
Right.
I'm not like you people.
Yeah, it's like, oh, yeah. It's like I can't stop eating chocolate or something
allergies
like that.
Allergies are for poor people.
Yeah, for losers. People with no control. I don't have any allergies. Like, that's insane. I don't have control over it. And if you don't have allergies, maybe you just need to move to Nashville, or maybe you just haven't tried that shellfish that you hadn't had before.
Right.
You know, and it's really not even like that you will get them. It's just that proud arrogance.
It's the proud arrogance. And I
am not
feel
one
like,
of you.
if they're saying, no, I don't have allergies and I never will, they're lacking self-awareness in my mind. Because, like, maybe he's right. Maybe you did have a sniffly nose or your eye watered one time. And they're like, no, it's not allergies. So, like, to me, it says more about the person that's lying because they don't have self-awareness of them, of themselves.
I never had allergies till I moved to Nashville. Well, it's like, my and wife was usually the same. There's kind of mild, unless it's really bad, then it affects me like crazy.
Yeah.
Sure. You know, there's one thing about his case about the, you know, oh, the guy said he doesn't have them and he never will. And he went along to, you know, started a cult, right?
Mm-hmm. Obviously.
You think about it, though, if you say, I don't have allergies and I never will, it's like he has delusions of grandeur that he can control everything. And so if he goes and has a, you know, starts a cult, isn't that also
a symptom
of I can control people?
Right. Yeah. Right.
Checks out.
Then he got reactions from people that tried the allergy test. He kind of explains it and has an example.
It never fails. Look at this DM that I got from somebody who did the allergy test on their first date. So they were on a first date with this guy and they asked if they had ever been allergic to anything. And the guy said he had never been allergic to anything ever. Now we know that's a red flag, right? Like if you ask somebody if they have allergies and they say yes, perfect. If they say no, that's okay. As long as they follow it up with something like that I know of or so far. It's the ones who are like insistent that they don't have allergies or they'll never get allergies. So this person was like, basically they didn't take it that serious until 2 days later, he tried to get me to join a secret group to overtake a political party.
This is intense.
Yeah.
This is intense. If you're just joining
us. Not expected.
Like, a couple minutes ago, he told us about somebody who, you know, failed the allergy test.
Right, said I don't have allergies and never will.
And then that person went and joined a cult and had like a whole bunch of wives. And yeah, it was sort of like super crazy. Mm. So like he's getting more confirmation that the allergy test works as a dating
I'm starting to believe
thing.
Him.
It's like an immediate red flag that they, yes, they are a narcissist.
Yeah.
Basically.
Yeah. I don't know. Narcissist? That's taken a little far.
No, you think so?
Well, I would say the I don't have allergies that I know of.
Well, then
that's
he
fine.
Says,
well, that's
but he
fine.
Said that's okay.
According
okay.
to the test, he says that's fine. As long as you have a qualifier, like not so far. Or
I'm starting to think that Woody's told people he doesn't have allergies, so now he's getting offended.
No, I never said never.
Never say never.
Never say never. I'm just trying to hide the fact that I am starting a cult in Idaho.
Yeah, that's what it seems like, you know? I'm getting those vibes here.
I'm trying to give you a little rodeo clown to get you away from that.
Right. Yeah, yeah. Like, perhaps I've said too much out loud. Right. Woody's secret life.
That's right.
There's got to be other like crazy things that are that. Like, people think of that are like, okay, these are my red flags for this that are completely outside the box.
Yeah,
right.
Like,
not your normal
they say
tests.
That, yeah, not a typical test, but like this guy who's just like, they say they don't have allergies, then they're clearly going to start a cult and they're insane.
Yeah, they're narcissists.
Yeah, and they're narcissists. Like, there has to be other ones.
I think a more simpler test would just say, do you like tacos? And if they say no, you just keep moving.
Yeah.
That, I agree with that. Mm-hmm. If you don't like tacos, you're insane.
See?
That's valid.
Trending. Here's what's trending this morning with Woody and Jim on 107.5 The River.
Brought to you by Mark Spain Real Estate. Zach.
A lot of people are complaining about waiting in like super long lines to renew their Tennessee license plates, but good news is that the state is actually giving us a small break on the registration fees. So the state of Tennessee is going to be waiving the state vehicle registration fee for a year starting this month. So you're not going to get your registration for completely free, but they're waiving the state portion of it.
Mm-hmm.
So you're getting like a $23 discount whenever
I'll
you renew
it.
Your license.
We'll take whatever we get.
Bring it all on.
Give me a discount. So this is happening all the way until June 30th of next year if you need to renew your license plates.
Cool.
Yeah. Jim, what you got?
So Tom Cruise, there was many rumors that he was going to be in the Doctor Strange Multiverse of Madness movie where anything could happen because alternate dimensions. People thought, oh, he's going to be in it and he's going to be this character. And there's people that are very much into the comics and stuff. They said he was going to make a cameo as Superior Iron Man, which I'm not familiar with. I can imagine what that is.
Probably a Scientology thing.
Right? he was not in that movie, but people are saying that the rumors are he is in talks to join the Marvel Cinematic Universe, possibly as that character.
Nah.
Tom Cruise, who turned 60 a couple of years
ago. Let's not do this.
I know. Maybe this could be just a rumor fueled by the massive success of Top Gun Maverick.
Right.
Yeah.
So maybe that's what's, you know, propelling this thing. But, you know, right now, that is a possibility. So love him or not.
Stay in your lane, Tom.
Yeah.
Ricky, what you got?
So we're experiencing a lot of shortages of things, a lot of supply chain issues, one of which is tampons. And it seems like no one's really talking about it, but there is a massive shortage of tampons. They're saying it's due to a combination of factory staffing challenges, the rising cost of raw materials to make the products. A lot of places like CVS, Target, Walgreens are really struggling to fulfill their orders of tampons. I personally went to go buy some yesterday, and there are basically none on the shelves.
What world is this?
Yeah, it's actually insane because no matter what, we don't stop menstruating, so we kind of need these things monthly because it happens monthly.
Your luxury items.
Yeah, like I know that we have to pay for them, which is insane, but it's even more wild that now we can't even pay for them and get them. So hopefully they figure this out soon. There are other options. I'm going to put together a blog of different things for you to try in case this lasts long term.
Home remedy?
Well, not home remedy.
Oh, God,
no.
Explain!
There are things like menstrual cups and Thinx panties, which are period-absorbing underwear. Okay. Things like that.
Okay.
There's nothing that's going to make you stop menstruating unless you get pregnant.
I thought there was like, you know, DIY stuff.
Oh, no. Other options.
You had to explain. That's why I asked.
No, I'm glad you asked so that I could explain, but no. That's not what I mean.
You're opening Tylenol. Don't throw that cotton away.
Yeah, no, guys. Honestly, it might get to that point if they don't figure it out, though.
Wow,
so,
hopefully they do soon.
Yeah, I hope so. There will be a blog at 107.5 The River. Just type in keyword Ricky.
Thanks for listening to and recommending the Woody and Jim Show podcast. Listen to Woody and Jim in real time every weekday morning on 107.5 The River, Nashville, or live on the iHeartRadio app.